Get ready to match the stars. Fred Travellina, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Riley, Monique Van Voren, McLean Stevenson, and Joyce Bulifant as we play the star-studded big money match game. And now, here's the star of match game, Gene Rayburn.
Hello there. Thank you. All ready to have a go at it? Thank you very much. You look smashing.
Speak to him about his pipe.
Don't you like the smell of a pipe? It's a
no, I quit smoking.
Rugged, he-man, macho smell. It's a sign of a man, a real man.
Now that I've got clear lungs, he's trying to clog them up again.
Let's say hello to Frida Delgado and Linda Fisher. Ladies.
Hi.
Linda won the first game. She lives down in Orange County, right?
Mm-hmm.
Close enough.
Close enough.
Ontario.
That's yeah. Close enough.
And she's a traveling salesperson, sort of,
that's
right?
That's true.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right. And so is Frida, as a matter of fact. Aren't
I don't travel. I just kind of sit there and answer phones and.
Oh, you do.
Do it all over the phone.
Really?
Yeah. Maybe. I'm well. Long distance, you see.
The interview is terminated. Let's carry on here. We're in the second game, and this is Linda's question. Frida had hers and matched three of our stars. Hey, have you seen the new soap opera about a farmer?
No.
No. It's called As the Blank Turns. All right. Well, I guess the lights burned out. Okay, Linda. Have you seen the new soap opera about a farmer? It's called As the Blank Turns.
As the crops turn?
As the crops turn.
Crops turn or change?
As the crops turn. Something about rotating the crops. What do you say?
Well, I said as the pig turns.
As the pig turns, yeah. On the spit.
Very leading.
Roast suckling pig.
Oh, boy. Doesn't that sound fabulous?
Oh, wonderful.
Oh, golly. No, I didn't say that. And this is an answer. It'll take a little time for you to get it, but once you get it, you're going to love it. As the worm turns.
As the worm turns.
See, they got it.
Right.
God love them.
There are a lot of worms on farms. They do beneficial things to the soil. They digest the soil and enrich it by eating it and eliminating it. Did you know that,
no,
Charles?
Point.
I know you're a sailor. You're not a farmer.
Tell us about the blue jay next, Uncle Gene.
Blue jays.
The earth.
As the earth turns.
Oh, very good.
When the plow gets going, the earth turns. Monique, new soap opera about a farmer called As the Blank Turns.
Well, I wanted to... What turns on a farm? I was thinking of milk, and then I thought of a cow.
Cow. As the cow turns. All right, we won't explore that. Another cowboy shirt, eh? They're good looking.
I have five of them. There's
oh, you have five of
no
them.
No end to this.
Oh, there is. Yeah. Kenny yeah. Rogers?
Yeah, Kenny gave me these.
Yeah. You work with him?
Yes.
Where?
We did a lot of stuff together. I don't have to tell you what we did. Did a special up in Steamboat Springs, Colorado.
Right. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Got a lot of cowboy stuff. Changed my life. I spit now, talk dirty, do everything I want.
Just because you met Kenny Rogers.
Oh, and just because I got the outfit. Went out to the Palomino Club Friday night, just beat the daylights out of a sissy in the parking lot. Had the best time I ever had in my life. Drank beer out of a bottle. And
really?
Just, yeah, got sick in the back of the Chevy and just had a hell of a time. I said, now, this may not be a match, but because I come from a farm town, from the movie Who Cares? Corn is a crop.
Corn is a crop. As the corn turns.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Yes, well,
all
only
right.
In America, folks.
Yeah. Joyce?
You might have to think about my answer a while before you get it. And then again, you might not get it, because I don't get it. But I wrote it down anyway. I thought it was utter nonsense.
As the udder turns.
But you don't turn it.
Oh,
you put
very
it.
Near.
That's right.
I know.
Yeah, you got to go back to the farm. Back to the farm for you, Joyce. All right, we go to round two.
No.
Now, Frida, you're ahead. That means you have to go first.
I'll take B.
All right, three people play. Fred, Charles, and Joyce.
Oh, boy.
Pete said it's dangerous going out with the Godfather's daughter. She has a face that could break your heart. Unfortunately, she has a father who could break your blank. Linda, he said it's dangerous going out with the godfather's daughter.
Turn.
Oh, it's Frida. Hello, Frida.
Hi.
I'm sick, Frida. I've got a bad cold and a sore throat.
I'm sorry.
Pete said it's dangerous going out with the godfather's daughter. She has a face that could break your heart. Unfortunately, she has a father who could break your blank.
Face. I had so many answers, I'll stick with face.
Could break your face. All right, that's not bad. Her face could break your heart, but her father could break your face. Whatever that means. They love you.
Best scene from Godfather 3.
Right.
My son, you are supposed to take over the business. And yet, you refuse. Why, my son?
I don't know. I guess I'm just different.
That will make up for my wrong answer. I said arms and legs.
No, that's a good answer.
Okay.
It's a very good answer. Her answer was not too swift. What'd you say, Charles?
Neck.
Yeah, another good one.
Neck.
No, Butch, those
tough going out with the godfather's daughter. A face could break your heart, or a father who could break your...
heart with a bullet.
With a bullet. All right. So, where are we? You got one shot at it. Three to tie, four to win. But first, we have this for you, Frank. All right. This is it. The last question of the last game. Linda. Mel said, you know you've had too much to drink at the party when the last thing you remember is taking a nap on top of your host's blank. Now I guess we're ready. So we'll come over here to Linda. Mel said, you know you've had too much to drink at the party when the last thing you remember is taking a nap on top of your host's blank.
Wife?
Wife is okay. A bold idea.
Yeah, may the Lord forgive the man that drank that much. Heel, yeah.
I said toilet seat.
I've been there myself, you know.
All right.
Oh, he's trash, you know. In his heart, there's a
but he's lovable.
Core of trash. Lovable, adorable, and trashy. But I love trash. I said beautifully set dining room table.
Right on the table. Charles?
What did she say?
She said wife.
Well, this could be a match. I really be lenient. Wife, is that a match?
That's close enough. Close enough for us. 3-1 the score. That too much to drink when the last thing you remember is take a nap on your host's blank. She said what?
Well, Linda and I must have gone to the same party or we know the same people because the host's wife.
Okay, that's 3-2 now. Did you go to that same party?
No, sir, I don't go to those kind of parties anymore now that I'm a cowboy.
Right.
We just drink a lot and beat up sissies.
Yes, Charles?
My back still hurts, too.
If he tries to touch you again, you let me know. I'll protect you.
I need a light in that parking lot.
Right.
Of course, there are some guys we're not too sure about, so we don't go too hard on them. I said wife.
All right. Joyce, here's the way it is. We have a tie score, 3-3. If you say wife, Linda will win. If you don't say it, it'll end up in a tie.
Oh, dear. I hate this. I said fell asleep on her potted plant.
On a potted plant. So the game ends in a tie, and that means we have to go to a tiebreaker, which we will do right now by pushing this button, revealing one tie-breaking question for each. The one who matches the most will be the winner. Frida, A or B?
B.
All right. Ed said, my wife is the world's worst cook. Her idea of a frozen dinner is a blank.
Mm-hmm.
terrible cook. Excellent. Here we go. Freedom. Ed said, my wife is the world's worst cook. Her idea of a frozen dinner is a blank.
Ice cream?
Is a ice cream?
Frozen. It's frozen.
Is a frozen ice cream. All right. All right, Fred, what do you say?
Well, I say that cold food can affect your voice.
That's
new
right.
Show. I said snowball.
A snowball. That would be a bad cook, right?
What is that when you take the... What makes that, because you know all these trivia questions, when you have a balloon and you let the air down into your throat and you go... Helium.
You take helium.
Helium.
You fill a balloon with helium and then take some of it in your lungs.
Is that what makes your voice feel like that?
Right.
Oh, ice cream.
Ah, all right.
Nice.
Hello, Captain.
That's what the cowboys were doing in the parking lot. They were taking helium, and they were so high. Now, maybe this is a match, I hope. Popsicle.
Popsicle is a wonderful answer. All right, Monique.
Everybody is thinking very cold, and so am I. Ice cube.
Ice cube. That's a good answer. What do you say?
A little fancier version of that, ice cube with gravy.
Ice cube with gravy. Oh, there's a dinner for you. Joyce?
Don't put the camera on this because I didn't know how to spell it.
It's all right.
But
we'll
it matches,
it.
So don't just popsicle. Popsicle.
Popsicle, it's all right. All right, three for Frida. Now, Linda.
Okay.
Three to tie, four to win. Rick said, you know your blind date is going to be really wild when you discover she keeps a joy buzzer in her blank. A joy buzzer is one of those gadgets that you buy in a trick store.
Yeah.
Right. And you put it in the palm of your hand, you wind it up, and you put it in your palm of your hand. It's a small device. And you go up and you shake hands with someone, and it goes brrrr.
Always related to a whoopee stick and all that stuff.
That's right.
Oh, I get it.
That's what a joy buzzer is.
Oh, that's
not... All right, we're about ready. Here we go, Linda. Rick said, you know your blind date is going to be really wild when you discover she keeps a joy buzzer in her blank.
Bra or underwear?
Bra.
Or undergarment?
Bra, all right. What do you say to that, friend?
I said, Brazia.
Uh-huh.
You would have won the score.
So she picks up one. Brett?
See, I went along with this whole thing, except that if one did actually put a joy buzzer in their, this area, and somebody made a small grab for it, you'd be in a bit of trouble, because those little suckers hurt, you know.
No, they don't hurt.
Sure they do. They go, and they give you a little shock.
No, they don't do that.
They go?
They just vibrate. And then when you embrace each other... You're way ahead of me. Go ahead.
Now, darling, Ira, be a nice person. Cleavage, isn't that the same?
That's close enough. You're putting a little lipstick on your lips there with the mirror.
No, the cowboys messed it up altogether.
Oh, I see.
Compact.
In a compact. Keeps a joy buzzer in her compact. Really wild.
Thank
you discover
you.
She keeps a joy buzzer in her... What do you say to that, Monique?
Well, after writing such a steamy novel as I did in Night Sanctuary, I have no more inhibitions, and I wrote... Panties.
Uh-huh. All right. That would be interesting. McLean?
What in the hell would you find fun in somebody who had a thing that went bzzzt in their pants for?
Where would you find someone who had it in their bra?
Well, it's wild. It was, you know, they got bombed and they didn't know what they were doing. It's like the time when you and Harvey Korman got bombed and you woke up in New Orleans and wondered how you got there.
Oh, that's yeah. All. With yeah. The whoopee cushion earmuffs.
That's right. Yeah.
Sat there and went...
Yeah.
Okay. I said jeans.
Jeans, that's okay. Now, it's 3-2, and Linda, you've got to match Joyce to stay in the game and achieve another tie. That would be tie number two.
That I would cause.
Yes.
I love ties. Pantyhose.
Ah!
Pantyhose.
That's lingerie.
No, that's not brassiere. She said bra. Come on down, Rita. If you would, please. Well, Linda, it was a pleasure to meet you. You have $2,750. Thanks for being on the match game. Linda Fisher. There she goes. Now, we got a little message for you. Hurry back.
The star of our show, Gene Rayburn.
Okay, Jen. Well, this is your first trip up here. How do you feel about it?
I'm very nervous and excited and everything.
Well, good luck to you, Frida. Let's have a go at it. We polled an audience and said, what do you think would be a good answer to this? No. Dwayne blank. Dwayne blank.
Brett.
Dwayne, this may be an old name. Charles may ask me to catch up. I say Dwayne Hickman.
All right.
Joyce.
Oh, shoot. I was going to say somebody, but I don't think that's his name. It isn't Dwayne Newton. It's Wayne Newton.
Yes.
Very good, dear.
Close enough. Dwayne Newton, you want to say
Dwayne. I'm going to say Dwayne Newton because I think the audience is silly as I am.
Dwayne Newton.
Fred.
I believe this is a name. Dwayne Bobic? Yeah.
Dwayne right. Bobic.
Who on earth would Dwayne Bobic be? Is he a football player or something
Dwayne
like that?
Dwayne Bobic. Dwayne Newton. Dwayne Hickman. Those are the three.
Dwayne Pipe.
Really?
Dwayne Pipe.
Dwayne Pipe. Yeah.
I think.
Do you want one of those or one of your own?
I'm gonna go with Brett's. Dwayne Hickman, because that's what I think.
Dwayne Hickman. Let's see if Dwayne Hickman's up there. We'll
Dwayne
go down
Newton.
To the bottom. Reveal a $100 response. Dwayne Thomas, a football. He's a football player and a very good one. All right. The $250 response says Dwayne Schneider. Who's Dwayne Schneider? I forgot. Who? One Day at a Time.
Never the Dwayne.
Oh, that's, Pat Harrington's character name on One Day at a Time, Dwayne Schneider. All right, the $500 response says Dwayne Hickman.
I don't understand why Dwayne Hickman.
I would have absolutely.
Now, Frida has $500. That means the least she'll play for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. However, she does have a chance to spin the wheel and double it up to $10,000. Have a go at it. Good luck.
Look at that mother go.
Yep, here. Yep. No. Just slid by. The big one there. You're playing with Brett for $5,000. Good luck to you. Here it is. Would you like a blank? Would you like a blank? Let me just show it to Brett. Make sure that she has the same understanding of it that you do.
Would you like a...
Yeah, that's what I said.
I know. Well, you know, this makes me very nervous.
Oh, it shouldn't. It's only money. It only means everything to her. You don't play this.
Oh, I don't.
No, you see, when we spin the wheel, Monique, it stopped on Brett's name.
I see.
When it stops
when
on your name,
on
then
name.
It'll... All right, your job is to match Brett. If you do that, you get $5,000. What do you say? Would you like a...
Can't think of anything, but would you like a drink?
Would you like a drink?
I hope there were two answers.
Playing with Brett Summers, I don't know what in the world ever made you think of that.
Well, you see, I was trying to. I'll read her mind. Now, I know what I would have said.
I know.
But you know, there was, would you like a kiss?
Would you like a kiss? So what did you
but
say?
But I didn't say kiss. I said drink.
$5,500. Congratulations to you.
Thank you.
Rita Delgado, big winner here. Now we've got this message for you.
Bye-bye.
We're on. 5 seconds. Oh, a quick goodbye. Goodbye. Quickly.
Bye-bye.
Thank
Bye.
You all.
You're join standing in my Gene picture.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to stand in your picture.
Today's contestants will also... For Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Trotman production. The program is edited for broadcast.